to another edition of Soccer As We Like It. My name is Tim Russell, your host, and today's edition is going to be based on the updates and roundup of all the weekend results. The good games, the good, the bad, the ugly, the fantastic games, the fantastic goals, the surprises and the non-surprises, good players, good managers, bad players. So that's what we're going to cover on this edition. We're going to cover the La Liga, Serie A, EPL and the Bundesliga, and any other soccer news that we could put into this content. First of all, we're going to hit the La Liga. La Liga has some very good games. We had the Real Sociedad and Atletico Madrid. This was an opportunity for Real Atletico Madrid to catch up with the top two teams. But unfortunately, they lost 2-0 to Real Sociedad. No one saw that coming. I mean, I couldn't believe that. I expected at least a draw. But over the weeks, before the season start, during when the season started, Atletico Madrid were drawing games and dropping points. But now, as we're coming into November, just before the international break, Atletico Madrid need to start winning games and getting these points and start climbing up the table, or they're going to be too far behind to catch up, because they have dropped to fourth place. So they need to start winning games. Losing 2-0 away, this is two back-to-back defeats they've had in the last 2 weeks. Okay, we move to the Bernabeu. Real Madrid and Laguna. Laguna lost 3-0 goals to nothing. That was expected. It was easy. It was a training game for Real Madrid. Just did a professional job. 3 goals, 2 goals from Gareth Bale, you know, signing on the back of his signing a mega million contract for Real Madrid. So I think it was a good opportunity for Real Madrid to show, but not really going into the top game. Just doing enough to get the 3 points. Celta Vigo and Valencia was another good game. I mean, Valencia, compared to the Valencia of last season, who, once they conceded the goal, they were completely capsided and decimated and disappeared completely off the face of the earth. But now there's that fighting, even though they lost 2-1 to Celta Vigo, who are a very good team. This Celta Vigo team beat Barcelona this season and last season. So it was a tough game for Valencia away. So they managed to lose just by 2-1, and I thought it was a good result for Valencia. It wasn't demoralizing, it was at least they played a good game. And the last game in that group I'd like to talk about was the Sevilla Barcelona. Barcelona coming off from a 3-1 heavy defeat in Manchester in the Champions League to Manchester City. Everyone thought, can they come back from this? Sevilla, on the back of successive Champions League wins, were on fire. They were really firing up for this game. But they always say, never underestimate the magic of Messi. Sevilla scored first. They were running at 100 miles an hour. 100 miles an hour. It was like 100 meter sprint. They were on the game. They should have won. They should have won the game in the first half 2-0. But that one goal against MSN wasn't strong enough. And after that point, Messi was marked out of the game. But once they broke through in the second half, it was curtains. Messi equalized and set up Suarez for the winning goal. So they lost at home 2-1 to Barcelona. And Barcelona are now only just 2 points away from Real Madrid. But there's still a lot of work to be done. It's still so early doors. So I won't say the league is won. It's too early. We're only in November. Let's quickly switch over to Serie A. Palermo away to a home to AC Milan. AC Milan on the back of trying to reduce the gap between them and Juventus, trying to close that gap. They got a good 2-1 victory away at Palermo. Inter, with a new manager after Frank de Boer was fired earlier in the week, they won 3-0 to Crotone. 3-0, they're playing well, but do players try to get managers fired? Why did they play like this weeks ago? It could be the team was a weaker team they played this week, but when any time a new manager comes in, teams try to impress. Players try to impress. But this isn't a new manager. He's the youth team manager who just come in to just fill the gap before they look for another big name to just fill in that spot. But with a good victory, Juventus and Chivas. Chivo, home to Juventus, the current four-time champions of the Serie A, back-to-back. I didn't feel it was going to be a hard game for Juventus, but Juventus did what they needed to do, got the 2 goals, thank you very much, goodbye and good night, and that was the end of Chivas. If it was a 2-1 victory, it looked close, but it wasn't close. It was just David and Goliath, that's how it looked like. And we're going to take our first commercial break at this part, so as you like it, stay tuned with us. Thank you. to the second part of our show, Soccer As We Like It. Thank you for staying with us. Right, we're going to go straight into the Bundesliga. At the Bundesliga currently, there are some surprise teams and surprise goings on in the Bundesliga. Not that a lot of people know about. Bayern Munich is only in Bayern Munich and Dortmund. But unfortunately, there's a team called RB Leipzig. RB Leipzig are top of the table, joint top of the table with Bayern Munich. Anyone heard of RB Leipzig? No. But they have 24 points. RB Leipzig, 24 points. This was a very tight. This looks like, this is the kind of Bundesliga I want to see, whereby it's not one team running away, another team is pushing the same, but you have RB Leipzig, you have Dortmund, who have dropped to sixth place, but a victory away to Hamburg, who are struggling the relegation, 5-2, took Dortmund up to fifth spot. But you have Bayern Munich, who won 3, who drew 1-1 with TSG. TSG is another team who are surprising everyone. TSG are third. So you have Bayern Munich, RB Leipzig, TSG, all fighting, giving Bayern Munich a run for the money. And Bayern Munich are not finding this comfortable. They're not finding, because they're not used to this kind of situation. But we'll see as the weeks go by. We'll be seeing all these results as they turn. I always say, and I repeat it, no leagues are won before Christmas. Never done. Because anything can happen. You could be leading by Christmas 10 points, but injuries, suspensions, it could all go wrong. Let's switch over to EPL. Were there some surprises? Yes, there were. Were there some great games? Yes, there were. Were there some bad games? Yes, there were. There are bad games everywhere. Right, let's really start with Bournemouth and Sunderland. Sunderland away to Bournemouth? Sunderland got the first away victory. First 3 points. I'm happy for David Moyes. He's been under so much pressure. I'm not a big fan of him, but he got Sunderland to win away the first 3 points away from home. Could you imagine that? They beat Bournemouth away 2-1. Jermaine Defoe got the final the penalty. And you see, Jermaine Defoe needs help and he's getting help. The strike force is getting better now. So with that, Sunderland with hope, they just need to tighten that defense up and they will be survived. So if they can, the trapdoor will tighten again. Instead of getting loose for them to drop down, it'll just stay if they can keep up the momentum. Crystal Palace away to Burnley. Crystal Palace have lost the last two games back to back. This is another third defeat. They've not won in the last four games. They lost 3-2 to Burnley. After coming back to 2-2, they threw the game away and lost at the last minute to Burnley. Burnley are playing very well. They are making sure they are not going straight back to the championship division. So they're fighting for every point. They play big. You saw what they did at Old Trafford a week ago. They played a 0-0 at Old Trafford. Today they won 3-2. So they got the victory, 3 points. Chelsea at home to Everton. Everyone thought that was going to be a tight game. But they dismantled Everton. In fact, it was embarrassing. 5-0. Everton, seriously, Everton? Krooman, really, mate? That was embarrassing, mate. 5-0. Chelsea are now top of the English Premier League, making them look like world beaters. Were Everton poor? They were pathetic. Now, quick overview to Anfield. Liverpool beat Watford 6-1. Watford, really, mate? Really, Watford? After beating Manchester United, nothing's gone right for you because you keep playing one win, one defeat. One win, one defeat. They got destroyed, humiliated, decapitated, decimated at Anfield by 6-1. My word, now that was a humiliation. Arsenal, the big London derby. Arsenal and Tottenham. Everyone expected fireworks. Arsenal at home. But if you look at it, over the last couple of games, against tough teams, Arsenal don't know how to break these teams down. That's how they drew 0-0 with Swansea. They beat Lazengrad. Okay, let's call that a training practice. Tottenham are not scoring a lot of goals, but Tottenham were not going to go lose, to lose ground at the top. So what they made sure they were not going to lose. In fact, it was a game of chess. It was a technical game, and the game ended 1-1. Good game, but a tight game. Now, Rob Bradley's first time against Jose Mourinho. If Swansea wins at home to Manchester United, it will be global news that the first American has beaten Manchester United, Jose Mourinho. It wasn't going to happen. That story, that fairy tale story, it ended. Pogba and Ibra destroyed that script instantly. It was 3-0 in the first 25 minutes. It was game done. Goodbye and good night. But, you know, United sat back and conceded one goal with a poor free kick lob into the box. Phil Jones was staring. Oh, he hasn't had match practice, but hey. But why was he there? He was there because the weakness of Chris Smalling and Luke Shaw telling Mourinho the morning of the match they couldn't make it. They were pathetic. Grow up, man. You guys earn too much to be too weak and too weak to play for Manchester United. Get a backbone, son. Get a backbone. United players, when they wear that badge, when they put that badge on, they make sure they give all for Manchester United. But you guys coming up with, we don't feel too good. Give it a rest, son. You earn too much to come out with, I don't feel good. Anyway, let's move on from that. Ronaldo signed a big, massive contract for Real Madrid this week, making him the highest paid Real Madrid player, and he's going to be there for another 5 years. Well done, CR7. Great job. Keep it going. Leicester, current champions of England, losing at home to West Bromwich Albion. I didn't see that coming. It messed up my prediction that week. I'm sorry, Leicester, what's going on here? You're 2 points above relegation. What's going on? Champions of England, not good enough. Ranieri, you got to sort this out because your train is going backwards, son. You got to fix it. Our last thing I'm going to cover is the West Ham Stoke City. I expected Stoke to go to London and not get beat. And they made sure they didn't get beat. Are West Ham playing well? Not really. They're not really playing well at the Olympic Stadium. I think they're struggling. I think if this game was Upton Park, it would have been game over. But fortunately, it's money that talks these days. Money talks. So they drew 1-1 Stoke City. Stoke City not lost in the last 5 games. Since that draw at Old Trafford, they have just catapulted themselves up the table. Good job, Stoke. Now we're having the international break, so we're not going to see you guys for another week. But we're going to cover some of the international matches, you know, the World Cup qualifications. So this stay with us. Soccer as we like it. Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on, we got a new YouTube channel. So give us a thumbs up, subscribe. Give us some support. Oh, that's all we need from you guys. Thank you very much. Soccer as we like it. We'll see you next week. Thank you.